Speaking of Harry Potter, there has been a sighting of a famous person from Harry Potter, and I'm talking about Dobby. You gotta look at this picture. So that's what Dobby looks like.
Dobby, looks just like him. That's
the
Dobby,
elf from
all right.
Harry Potter.
Oh, that's the real
yes,
Dobby.
That's the real one.
The house elf.
So there we go. So there was actual video. I'm showing you a photograph right here that was captured. It looks just like Dobby, the elf from Harry Potter. And Vivian Gomez, she's the one who shared this. And this is part of CCTV footage. Security cameras showed this creature walking through her driveway.
Not just even walking, but like flailing the way Dobby does. You
it's
know, he
pretty
was really
bizarre.
It's really crazy.
So the thing is, obviously, it's got a ton of views right now. It's going viral on social media, and people are saying that it is fake and someone put this together. She's saying, no, this is not put together. And I've watched the video 1,000 times, and I sleep with the lights on right now. So how creepy is that? I don't know, maybe Dobby is planning a trip to go to Universal and check out the new ride. I don't know.
You know, Dobby's handy to have around. I wouldn't be so worried about it. He's, you know, helpful. He's the house elf. That's what they do. They're there to lend a hand. So, I don't know. If you are going to make that trip to Universal, make sure if you're packing a carry-on, I guess you don't have to fly there from here, but other people do. So, when you're traveling, especially by air, you're going to bring a carry-on on, and there are some things that are recommended that you don't forget to pack.
Yeah, so we have a list of the top 10. And actually, before the show, we were talking about this, and this is pretty much spot on. So, definitely pay attention, because let's face it, when you are packing for a trip, a lot of times you're in a hurry and you're forgetting the most basic things. So number one, hand sanitizer or wet wipes. Mm-hmm. Both of them are great to have, especially when you have kids because they touch everything. I don't know about you, but I have a lot of that stuff with me at all times. Not even just a trip, just all the time.
You can always find a couple of little sample size ones in every glove box, every place that there's somewhere to store in my car. A change of clothes, obviously, you don't know if they're going to lose your luggage this trip or the next one. You just want to make sure you're not caught with nothing to change into. And again, if you have little ones, sometimes things happen and they need a change of clothes.
That's one of them I never do myself, but we always do with the kids. But that is a great idea because if you don't get your bags, obviously, you need to do something or you have to rock whatever, wherever you land, like that type of stuff.
Or go shopping.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so maybe it's an excuse to do that. Water bottle. A lot of times people will have an empty one to get through security and then just fill it up later. Mm-hmm. It will save you a lot of money.
A lot of money.
Yeah.
A travel pillow. I'm not so sure about the travel pillow for me because it seems like every time I've tried to do that, it's not as comfortable as my husband's shoulder, but if you don't have my husband with you, you might want to have a travel pillow.
Yeah, it's a great route to go, especially the ones that you can inflate because obviously they're so small, you know, to pack up. Another one is a pen. Now, in this day and age, let's think about it. You know, we're always digital with everything that we're doing, but it is good to have something
to write
with. Well,
they're going to make you turn your phone off, right?
Exactly.
So you need your pen.
So I like that one. A shawl is something you have at all times. There's one right over there.
I have my blanket. It's my shawl. I just sit here. Oh, Ryan, do you mind grabbing my shawl? Thank you. And
it's pretty fancy.
Noise canceling headphones here. This is what I do all the time. Those are good, not just because you want to listen to something, but because you want to make sure the person sitting next to you knows that you're not in the mood to talk
That's
to them.
That's why I have them 100%. Even if there's nothing on, you know, like I'm not going to be rude, but sometimes I just want me time. It's really important to have.
me time.
In-flight entertainment. This is huge. Again, especially with kids. Another idea, if you don't have, you know, like electronic devices, a lot of times kids, you go to the dollar store and pick up little like board games or coloring books. As long as it's new and they haven't played with it before, it will keep them occupied. So that's a good one to
have. That's key. It can't be something they've already used.
Yeah.
Healthy snacks, that's going to save you from having to pick up something that's not so good for you and that is very marked up at the airport.
Like a Cinnabon.
Like a Cinnabon. And then
they're delicious. You jacked up on sugar.
Yeah, but you know what?
Sugar and carbs where you sit for 3 hours.
You're only at the airport occasionally. Get a Cinnabon, but also pack some healthy snacks for the kids.
Right,
you,
exactly.
Yeah, you get the Cinnabon. And then a power bank because hell have no wrath like a child who's iPhone is dead on a long trip.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely. Now, this is something that's been a huge debate. So when you are traveling, the person who sits in the middle, do they get to have both armrests? So the Rich Eisen Show, they were talking about this, and it went viral on Twitter. Over 99,000 people weighed in on this, and it was a heated debate on what to do. And there was a traveling expert that said, actually, the person in the middle, they do have quote unquote, the rights to claim both armrests.
Our etiquette expert, Kay Simonetta, joined us once, and she was talking about travel etiquette, and she did say the person in the middle seat is entitled to both armrests. I don't personally feel like I would do that just because I think I'd have to then explain, listen, I've consulted some etiquette experts and this is actually okay to do. Because I feel like most people wouldn't know that that's like really my right. But at the same time, you know, you're getting the raw end of the deal no matter what.
You totally are. So. And it's kind of first come, first serve. I feel like if somebody's already claiming it, I always feel weird.
Yeah.
So I'm like, hey, buddy, do you mind if I put my arm up there?
Right.
You know, so it's awkward. Now, we have a poll up on YouSay. Go to newsforjax.com/YouSay and weigh in. It's simply a yes and no. And right now, no is 60%. So they do not have the right to do that.
Yeah, but then whose arm do they get? Because
right.
you're taking away from somebody, right? So... I don't know.
Yeah. So that is, I kind of feel like if somebody's already sprawled out, that's why I guess it is important to get on that plane first. You ever notice that? Because they're already comfortable. And then
yes.
you feel like you're their guest when you get to that little aisle. I'm like, hey, how you
doing? Do you choose if it's just you flying? Which seat do you want?
I usually like the window because I could do this.
Yeah, that's a good one.
the whole time.
And
what
I like
you?
The aisle because I know I'll probably have to get up at least one time and I don't want to have to bother anyone.
Now, when you get up, because you have to go to pee, do you announce it?
No, not if I don't know the people. I feel like I don't, you know, no.
Excuse me.
Now,
what about if you're in the window? Do you announce
then
it?
Then you have to announce it.
Yeah, because then it's like, well, where are you going?
Excuse me for
which
just
is obvious because there's only one thing you could be doing to get up in the
excuse
aisle.
Excuse me, I'm going to go give the captain some advice on flying this plane. I'll be right back.
Exactly.
I mean, that's the only place you can go, right?
Seriously. But again, these are great tips, and it goes all the way to the beginning where we talk about the 10 things to bring on, you know, for carry-on to having, you know, the seat. And that's why maybe it's a good idea, again, to pre-plan and pick your seats out. And then if you are traveling with kids, put them in the middle because they don't have a say then, right?
Yeah, then you get all the armrests because they have the little arms. There you go. And then you can even tuck their little arms in their seatbelt, and then they're done.
And give them a little healthy snacks while you eat your Cinnabon. Sounds like a travel
plan. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back with more River City Live.